A key part of any VMS installation is adding and configuring cameras and other devices. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to configure cameras. We can do this in two ways. Configure one camera at a time in the device properties, or group cameras into device groups and configure the common settings for all cameras in the group. First, we'll look at individual configuration. Let's look at the configuration options for one of the Axis P3301 cameras. We'll also look at the different device settings, so you'll be able to configure cameras on your own. We need to click the plus sign on the last Axis P3301 camera in the list to expand the list of devices. You can now see the available devices and whether or not they are enabled. We want a hardware switch to work with the device, so before we start configuring the camera, we need to enable the input device. To do that, we right-click the input device, and then click Enabled. As you can see, the input device is now active. Now, we can proceed with configuring the camera. Click the Axis P3301 camera device in the list. We do all configuration for the camera in the Properties pane. The properties are distributed across several dedicated tabs. On the Info tab, you can view and edit basic information for the camera. Let's click the Settings tab to continue. On the Settings tab, you can view and edit settings for the device. The content of this tab depends on the device driver and differs from device to device. On this tab, you define the image quality for the various streams the camera supports. We'll click the Streams tab to continue. On the Streams tab, you configure multi-streaming. Let's look at the Record tab next. The VMS saves recordings from a device only when you have enabled recording. In the Storage section of the Properties pane, you can monitor and manage the databases for the device. We'll click the Motion tab next. On the Motion tab, you can enable and configure motion detection for the selected camera. The settings determine when the system generates motion events and typically also when video is recorded. Here's a demonstration of how to adjust motion sensitivity. Here, you can see how to adjust the trigger point for motion detection by adjusting manual sensitivity and threshold. The higher the sensitivity level, the less change is allowed in each pixel before it is regarded as motion. The lower the sensitivity level, the more change is needed. Let's click the Fisheye Lens tab to continue. On the Fisheye Lens tab, you can enable and configure fisheye lenses if you have cameras that support this. You can choose from a list of lens types and also specify camera placement. Now, let's view the Events tab. In addition to the system's events, you can configure some devices to trigger events. You can use these events when creating event-based rules in the system. Technically, they occur on the actual hardware device rather than on the surveillance system. Let's click the Client tab. On the Client tab, you specify which other devices you view and hear when you use the camera in the Smart Client. You also enable live multicast here. Finally, we'll click the Privacy Mask tab. Using privacy masking, you can cover areas of the camera image before distributing it to the clients. In this example, we don't want to expose the information on the wall. With privacy masking enabled, when operators view the camera, the area will not be visible to them. You just saw how to configure a camera using device properties. Visit our YouTube site to view other tutorials in this playlist.